In this day and age, parallelism has become fundamental to computer systems. Any general-purpose CPU chip has multiple cores in it. Every general-purpose operating system is designed to take advantage of such hardware parallelism. In this unit, we will study the basic algorithms for synchronization, communication, and scheduling in a shared memory multiprocessor, leading up to the structure of the operating system for parallel machines. We'll start today's lecture with a discussion of the model of a parallel machine. A shared memory multiprocessor, or a shared memory machine, we can think of three different structures for this shared memory machine. The first structure is what we call a Dancehall architecture. And a Dancehall architecture is one in which you have CPUs on one side and the memory on the other side of an interconnection network. And let me say something that is common to all the three structures that I'm going to describe to you. The common things are that in every one of these structures, there's going to be CPUs, and there's going to be memory, and there's going to be an interconnection network. And the key thing is, it's a shared memory machine. What that means is that the entire address space defined by the memories is accessible from any of the CPUs. So that's one common thing that you'll see in all the three styles that I'm going to talk to you about. And in addition to that, you'll see that there is a cache that is associated with each of these CPUs. So this is a Dancehall architecture. And the next style is what is called an SMP architecture, or a symmetric multiprocessor. Here what you see is the interconnection network that I showed you from the Dancehall architecture. I've simplified it considerably, showing a simple bus, a system bus that connects all the CPUs to talk to the main memory. And it is symmetric because the access time from any of the CPUs to memory is the same. And that's the idea of the system bus that allows all of these CPUs to talk to the main memory. The other thing that you'll notice, as I already mentioned, is that every CPU comes equipped with a cache. And we'll talk more about the shared memory machine and the caches in a minute. So the third style of architecture is what is called a distributed shared memory architecture. So in this distributed shared memory architecture, what you have, or a DSM for short, is that you have memory, a piece of memory that is associated with each CPU. And at the same time, each CPU is able to access all of the memories through the interconnection network. It is just that the access to memory that is close to this guy is going to be obviously faster than trying to access memory that is farther from here, which has to be accessed through the interconnection network.